Can we call up John Chandler just so that we don't, we're not asking Elsie questions that they may not want to answer or be prepared to answer? Chandler will answer them, I'm sure.
I don't mind questioning Mr. Chandler. So
you weren't going to get out of this. You know that, right?
Yeah, so the question is affordable housing, and in affordable housing that is sold or rented to people that are below median wage, and yet this is new construction, and affordable housing that is built basically to government standards by government mandates, you typically cost more than just a standard housing that you would build, whether it's an apartment complex for the private sector. Can you just kind of elaborate a little bit on that?
Madam Chair, member of the committee, for the record, John Chandler, Oregon Home Builder Association. Your question, Representative Barreto, most of my clientele wouldn't be building those units. They're going to be built by nonprofits and others that are using a variety of government and other sorts of grant loan programs that are administered by NGOs. And the people who actually play in that sandbox to do that kind of affordable housing, and it is new construction, you're absolutely right, believe this will be helpful to them to give them a little faster track through the land use approval process. Your underlying point, if I understood you correctly, about how sometimes those programs that are designed to increase affordable housing also increase the cost of affordable housing, I personally would agree with outside the, but this isn't trying to address that. This is simply saying if you're doing these kind of affordable housing projects and you bring an application into the city, instead of 120 days to approve that, the city needs to turn it around in 100 days, which is obviously time being money and development. That's going to make things go a lot more quickly.
Okay, and it says a county. So it says a county cannot deny an application. So if someone wants to build this, or if the state comes in, or you have a grant to do this, the county cannot deny that. Is that what this is saying? Is that they have to allow these properties to be built, and then they're also. I mean, I just skimmed through this. I have to apologize because I started looking at this an hour ago. It's a 29-page amendment stuff to a bill that came out of the Senate. 28-0, and I'm a little frustrated that we do these things at the last second and try to put out good policy, you know, at the last minute. I mean, this is kind of this shouldn't be the way business is handled here. So, so I'm looking at this saying, look, affordable housing costs more. The taxpayer has to pay for that, whether it's through grants or some other funding, even whether it's a nonprofit. Typically, it comes back to the taxpayer having to do this at prevailing wage. It costs more money, and now you're saying counties or cities have to basically comply with this, and they're forced to be under these constraints or under this ruling.
Madam Chair, Representative Barreto, first let me apologize on behalf of all of us who are working on this bill for the fact that it's in front of you. It wasn't our idea to put it in front of you. It stalled out on the other side of the building, a previous iteration of this particular concept. We've been working on it for quite a while, this session and the substantive committee and in ways and means. That said, the bill, actually, the point you're asking about as far as having county cities and counties having to comply is or approve is not the piece on affordability. This has separate kind of segments that we were trying to figure out over the interim ways to improve housing production. We have a housing shortage in this state of probably close to 100,000 units since the recession, and so there have been a variety of bills this session, some of different takes on how to address that. This idea is to try to increase housing production generally, not just affordable housing, but a housing market rate as well, on the theory that if you have a 100,000 unit deficit, the more you build, the more it's easier going to get the prices down for the existing and new stuff. The affordable piece that you mentioned in your first question deals with the first piece of that shortening the time of approval from 120 days to 100. Same language or the same criteria apply in the language in the bill where it says churches can do affordable housing projects on their property. Those are the part in the bill where it says cities and counties have to approve has to do with clear and objective standards requirements, which are different from the affordability requirements. We're attacking a bunch of different problem areas in the housing approval process. process, and it is confusing to look at it as 29 pages of what appears to be a seamless fabric, and in fact has a variety of little segments to it. I can certainly walk through the intent behind those sections if you want, if the committee has time, or I can try to respond to another question.
Follow up question.
Mm-hmm, sure.
So would you say that the primary objective of this bill is to expedite the opportunity to build housing, whether it's affordable or not?
Madam Chair, Representative Bretto, absolutely. That is the point of the exercise. We are trying to get more housing built, full stop.